You have your MetaQuest 3, you have your link cable, you have your sim rig set up, and you're ready to dive into the incredible immersive world of VR in Assetto Corsa. In this video, I'll walk you through the steps to make this happen so you can start feeling the adrenaline rush of high-speed sim racing. And I'll also be showing you which settings you need to change to get the best image and performance possible out of your headset to make Assetto Corsa look incredible, so stick around at the end of the video for that. So first, let's go over the four essential components we'll need. So we need Assetto Corsa installed, we need Content Manager installed, Custom Shaders Patch installed, and Pure installed. Now, if you don't have any of that, don't worry. Go and check out this video I'm putting on screen right now, which is my beginner's guide to Assetto Corsa. That video will show you where to get everything you need, how to install it, and how to get Assetto Corsa up and running. Once you've watched that video, come right back here so we can get you fully immersed into VR in Assetto Corsa. Right, so now you've got Assetto Corsa up and running, let's get into this. So firstly, download and install the Oculus Quest desktop app onto your sim rig. There will be links down in the description below for everything that you need. Once that's installed, run that application, click on the devices on the left-hand side towards the bottom. Now, connect your Quest 3 using your link cable to your sim rig and power it on. Give it a few seconds and it will eventually show up as a device in the Oculus app. Now, a really important tip here is to run the USB link cable test. So to do that, click on the headset and then scroll down until you see USB test towards the bottom. Click on that and then click on test connection. Now give that a few seconds to run, and if the app shows a compatible connection with a green tick, you're good to go. If it reports there's an issue with speeds or that it's not connected to a USB 3 port, then connect it to a USB 3 port and run the test again. Now once that's done, click quit test and minimize the Oculus app. Next, you need to open up Content Manager. And if you don't know what Content Manager is or what it does, it's a launcher application for the Assetto Corsa game. And what it allows you to do is it allows you to configure every element of the game all in one place. So it will help you with how the game looks, how the game feels, what weather you would like. You can choose if you want to drive in a practice, a race, a race weekend, drifting, and just so much more. Now, another bonus tip here. We're going to click on Settings, Assetto Corsa, and we're going to look down for Controls. We're going to then click on System on the right-hand side at the top there. Then we're going to look for Reset Camera in VR. And as you can see, I've got mine mapped to button 25 on my wheelbase. If you click into here, it says waiting for input. If you press a button on your steering wheel, it will map this function to that button and it will become clear why later on in this video. So next we're going to go to Settings, Assetto Corsa, and we're going to click on Video. Now, lucky for you, the very helpful people over at the Custom Shaders Patch Discord server have an entire channel dedicated to VR for Assetto Corsa and getting the most out of it. Now, I strongly recommend joining this server because not only is it full of very friendly people, but there is a pinned document in the VR channel with pages and pages of useful information on all of the settings that you need to be aware of to getting the most out of VR in Assetto Corsa. And what they've done is they've split out the settings of this video section here that you're looking right on the screen into three PC spec types. So there's a low spec, there's a medium spec, and there's a high PC spec. So choose the one that's right for you and match these settings in Content Manager. But before you do, here's another useful tip. Now, if you use Assetto Corsa already, these may be your video settings that you've set for maybe for use on a monitor. So what I would suggest you do if you haven't done already is go down to the bottom and click Save Preset and save this as something like Monitor, for example, because what we're going to do next is we're going to change the settings here for VR. And having those settings saved and being able to switch between them very, very quickly is very useful indeed. If you're finding this video useful, drive straight into that subscribe button for more content like this. Now, to save you some time, I've loaded these custom shader patch presets, the low, medium and high settings into my content manager for you, and I'll show these on screen now. So firstly, here's the settings for a low end PC, and I'll leave these on screen for you, or feel free to pause the video. So next are the mid-tier PC settings here that I'm showing now on screen for you. And finally, the high-end PC spec settings. Now, I have an RTX 4090 GPU with a 14900K Intel CPU, so that's a higher-end spec PC, and the Ultra settings are the settings that I use for Assetto Corsa. Now, I just wanted to comment on a few settings on this page. Firstly, about PP filters. Now, they are subjective, meaning that a PP filter that I like might not be right for you. Now, there are so many free and paid versions out there, and Race Department is a great resource for these. Anyway, the one that I use for everything is NV Photo Realism. It is a paid for mod. It's only £3. I will leave a link down in the description below if you want to try these out, but I can highly recommend it. I found that it works very, very well in every weather condition. Next, I wanted to talk about the resolution. There seems to be a little bit confusion as to if this is the resolution that the headset runs at, and it is not. That's controlled by the Oculus app resolution scale settings, which we saw earlier. This setting is used for the in-game HUD, so the in-game menu systems. And because of that, I found 1920 by 1080 to be a good resolution. And lastly, it's the anisotropic filtering setting. So you'll see here that I've got it turned off in Content Manager, and there's a very good reason for that. So the pinned comment that I mentioned earlier in the Custom Shaders Patch Discord server, they explain quite rightly that having the graphics card handle the anisotropic filtering is a far better performance benefit than setting this here in the game and therefore having your CPU handle it. So that's why I have it turned off here. So it's almost time to jump into Assetto Corsa, but before we do that, there's one last thing we need to do, and that is we need to enable the link cable connection between the PC and the Quest 3. Now we're going to press the Oculus button on the controller, and we're going to click on the date and time, which is a quick shortcut to quick settings, and you can see Quest Link there. We're going to click on that. There's the PC, it says connected, and we're just going to click enable. And then after a short few seconds, you'll see there we are. We are now in Quest Link. So now lift up the headset, and we're going to go back to Content Manager. If you click Drive at the top, choose a car and a track. Choose practice mode and then click go at the bottom. Put the headset back on and wait for the game to load. Now, if you're like me and you're not perfectly still when the game loads, you might find that the VR image isn't centered. If that's the case, simply grab your steering wheel, look forward and press the button that you mapped earlier. This should then center the image for you. And that's it. You're now good to start driving in VR in Assetto Corsa. But what if the image doesn't look sharp or crisp, or it just looks rubbish? Well, there are three areas which will affect this. The first is in the video settings in Content Manager. Now, we've already discussed three sets of settings in Content Manager, and by now you should have chosen one that best suits your PC. The second area is in the Oculus app. Now, by default, the refresh rate is set to 72 Hz. Personally, I changed mine straight away to 90 Hz and then started testing other options. Now we come on to rendering resolution, and by default, this is set to 1.0. So if we untick the automatic setting, we're going to be able to adjust the slider here at the bottom. Well, I would recommend increasing this by one at a time and testing out the results. Changing this setting will increase the image quality significantly, but it does come at a performance cost, so this is a balance. And the final area is within the Oculus debug tool. Now, to run this, navigate to the folder where you installed the Oculus app. Mine is on my E drive, but yours might be different. Now, if you go into the support folder and then into Oculus diagnostics, you'll see the Oculus debug tool there. Now, before you double click it, here's another bonus tip. Right click it and choose create shortcut. You will then see a message asking you if you would like to create the shortcut on your desktop and choose yes. Next, find that shortcut on your desktop and double click it. Now, I've left all the other values at default, but the one in particular we're going to pay some attention to is the encode bitrate. Now, by default, this field is set to 0, which is around 130 megabits per second. To increase this, I'd recommend using increments of 100. So start by setting this to 200 and test it and increase it by 100 at a time. Now you'll see that there's a maximum value that you can freely type into this field, and that value is 500. Now, as you'll see, if I try and type 600 into this field, I can't actually do it. So what you need to do is to open something up like Notepad and key in the figure that you want. So as an example, 600. Then copy that to the clipboard and then simply paste it into the field and hit enter. Another bonus tip here is when you're testing these values, I'd recommend that you have a performance overlay shown in the VR headset to help you see how the headset and the PC are performing. As you'll see down here in the Oculus Debug tool, it actually provides one for you. So set the visible HUD to performance and then set the mode to performance summary. Now, I can't tell you what values you need to set to get the most out of your PC and your headset. The values you arrive at will depend entirely on your PC specifications. Now, if you want to take your sim racing experience to the next level, check out the video that's on screen right now where I discuss 10 game-changing apps every sim racer needs. Catch you in the next one.